Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time. Time for what? Our main event.
This is set for one fall. Introducing first from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 206 pounds, Daivari.
Well, here he comes. And what a shock. Daivari's angry. My line. Speaking of being angry, Shawn Michaels did not look to be in a good mood either this past week on Raw when he shocked everyone in attendance by coming out and super kicking the WWE champion Randy Orton. The Heartbreak Kid had really been in the back of our minds and we'd really forgotten about him. And who would have thought? Wait a second.
Man mikham beporsam ki tu in sakhtemun en shab mikhad.
I always agree with what he has to say.
فقط از شماها یه سوال دارم یه سی ازتون میپرسم کی از اون پشت بیرون بیا به دست دیوری بیا به دست من حالا اگر تونستی بفهمید
Introducing next from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 232 pounds, Cody Rhodes.
There's a young kid with a lot on his plate right now, wouldn't you say? Well, Cody Rhodes, this week on Raw, will be facing Hardcore Holly, hoping to break that two-match losing streak. But first things first, he's got to deal with Daivari here on Heat. Cody has got to concentrate with Hardcore Holly waiting in the wings on Raw, trying to earn his respect. He's got to earn Daivari's respect, because what will it mean if Cody goes into Raw after having losing
after to having
Daivari?
Lost.
Having lost, that's what I meant to say, to Daivari this week on Heat. He's got to concentrate. You didn't get to finish your run. Well, my point was about Heartbreak Kid is that we had forgotten about it. Anytime a superstar is gone for 3 or 4 months, you forget that they're even on the roster. And I think young Randy Orton forgot as well, and he was the most shocked out of anybody what happened at the end of Raw. So Shawn Michaels is back. What does that mean to the WWE Championship picture? Who knows? I'm sure Shawn Michaels not only wants Randy Orton, the man, but he wants what he's got around his waist too. Is Shawn Michaels, you'll remember who was the man that put Shawn Michaels out? Randy Orton. And now Randy Orton's the WWE champion. How sweet would it be if not only Shawn Michaels comes back, but comes back and beats Randy Orton and becomes the WWE champion? Cody Rhodes showing off some strength. Daivari trying to whip him off the ropes, but Cody not letting go of that side headlock, and now taking Daivari down, hooking the leg, and a two. Cody really has impressed me in the first few months that he has been here in making a name for himself and getting out from underneath his father's shadow, Dusty Rhodes, and trying to pave his own way. But I think in doing so, he may be biting off a little bit more than he can chew, hence taking on Hardcore Holly yet again this coming week on Raw. Oh boy, Daivari telegraphing that. Gets a face full of boot for his measure, but right in the rib cage. That hurts the rib cage. It can torque your shoulder and hurt all kinds of different things.
Get him out of the corner. Come on, Daivari.
Cody Rhodes has to be very careful as to not look past this match. And I'm sure right now he's thinking about nothing but Daivari. And Daivari just firing away on the son of Dusty Rhodes. Daivari is certainly no pushover. He's a guy that can beat anyone on any given night. And like you said, always seems to be in a bad mood because nobody is ever on his side.
This crowd certainly getting behind Cody Rhodes. Cody up to that vertical base now and backing Daivari into a corner.
Oh boy.
Cody just can't get his breath back after taking that shot to the ribs. Two. And Daivari very wisely just trying to cut off that circulation, squeeze in on those injured ribs.
And I think he's saying, hey, I'm in better shape than Cody Rhodes is. I'm going to continue to, as you said, work on the ribs, but also wear Cody Rhodes down because to try and take this approach, you've got to be in very good cardiovascular condition. Well, the one question mark surrounding Cody Rhodes is his consistency. At one point, you told Cody, hey, you've got to win tonight or you're off the Raw roster. He responded then. Can he respond now?
It's all about putting these youngsters under pressure and see how they respond. If they can't respond when the big lights are on, then they don't deserve to be here. Just because of his last name doesn't mean he deserves to be on the roster.
We mentioned that Cody has lost twice in a row to Hardcore Holly. Really needs a win tonight to get some momentum, to have some positive energy as he heads into the third match with Hardcore this week on Raw.
Well, and that match is going to be taking place overseas. And that's thing he's got to fight off is that that pro-Hardcore Holly European crowd.
A jawbreaker by Cody Rhodes gives him a small reprieve, but Cody hasn't been able to do anything about it when he gets a few seconds to catch his breath. Here he goes, though, a couple of big rights and a clothesline. And another.
I will say this, the young kid has a lot of heart. He's got a lot of quickness.
Moxie.
That's another word you could use. But he needs the 1-2-3.
It may come right here.
No. Almost, but you're not facing a pushover. You're facing Daivari.
Well, Daivari extending a hand in a goodwill gesture. Cody says, not today, my friend.
I think he's done some homework on Daivari.
Ducking the clothesline, power slam. Got the leg, two, no.
Wow,
that was quick.
Chad Patton right on top of it, and Daivari nearly was beaten by young Cody Rhodes.
One thing Cody is very quick. He's agile, he's flexible. Wait a minute. And there it is, proof of the pudding.
And a little skittage of the cabbage.
Going low, DDT! Cody Rhodes just DDT'd Daivari. Will he kick out? He will not. Cody wins.
So winner of this match, Cody Rhodes.
Well, I will say this. Cody Rhodes came in this week with a focus, knocking off Daivari. The young ladies loved it as well. Big win for Cody.